sister to be so close to her.
Ever done anything like this before?
Yeah, Bismarck as a grad student, and Lusitania on vacation a couple of years back.
Hell of a resume.
Alright, I've reached the seabed. Can't see much.
You're still a couple of hundred meters out, and back to manual control. Shall we run an equipment test?
Sure, let's do this by the book.
First, let's run through the controls on the panel in front of you. The center left joystick... Great, now let's check the altitude controls. The lever to your right will allow you to ascend and...
Looks good.
Now, in the middle of the console, there's a map of the site showing your current location in blue. The yellow flashing point is your current goal position. I'll update the map and your goal locations as we go through contracted jobs. If you need to reorient your spotlight, it's the lever on your left.
Gotcha.
And if you look up, there's a set of VR goggles with a screen. This is the control panel for the Predator.
Ah, the ROV.
Yep, courtesy of Flight Avionics and the latest in augmented reality technology. Should let us explore some hard-to-reach areas.
Is that it for the checklist?
That's it for now. Okay, you'd better place a marker before we head too far. Interact with the button next to the map to place one.
Marker's been placed.
You can head towards the bow. So, I had a call from our main sponsor.
Problem?
No, all fine. Just voicing her excitement about us finally diving. Said she's looking forward to seeing what we can do. I've set up a call for 8 p.m. this evening.
For $45,000 a day? Let's just hope we find something.
Never mind the money. My doctorate is riding on this.
Whoa.
There's something you don't see every day.
She's a beauty.
Okay, first things first. We've got a contract with the Titanic Society to place their commemorative plaque on the forecastle deck. Get yourself into position.
All right.
Deploy the Predator. The plaque is in its storage compartment.
How do I access the compartment?
Through the menu on your right-hand controller.
Okay, moving towards the spot now.
Great. Just remember what I said about these new ROVs. The range is only up to 15 meters. The advantage of driving without an umbilical.
Is there any way to boost the signal?
Yeah, but we need to upgrade the deep-sea transmitter, and they don't come cheap. The generosity of our sponsors and UNS funding only goes so far. If we complete these contract jobs, we might just be able to afford some upgrades.
What happens if I go out of range?
The automatic recall kicks in. ROV comes straight back to the sub. This breach is from the impact with the ocean floor. Anything in here is going to be messy.
I'll keep my eyes peeled. WJH. I think this is it.
Well, that's lucky. Are you going to open it?
No, not here. Assuming there's anything intact in there, it'll start degrading as soon as I open the case. I'll have to bring it back to the lab before we can take a peek.
Well, don't take too long. I want to see what's inside. Let's get you to the surface. Activate the autopilot and get comfortable.
Alright, I'll see you in about 2 hours.
Whoa, looks to be in good condition.
Let's get this cleaned up. A bone hair comb. I'll need to wash the salt out quickly before it crystallizes and the bone starts to crumble. It's ready for drying in the acetone bath. Silver doesn't look great after being in the ocean. This tobacco tin is covered in silver sulfide. I'll have to gently wash this using a soft brush, making sure I don't scratch the surface underneath. It's come up great. These banknotes are delicate, and we'll need a good rinsing in the desalination bath. Then we can treat them in the fungicide to keep them clean, before freeze-drying them. This journal is pretty special. The pages seem to be a fabric-paper blend. I think the desalination bath will leach out the salt. Then it can go into the PNG station before freeze-drying. This leather case is looking pretty sturdy, but it will need a good soaking in the desal tub to remove the salt. Then I can give it a gentle scrub with the nylon brush. Clean, it needs to be soaked in PEG and fungicide to soften the leather and stop it from cracking. Alright, it's ready for freeze drying.
Whoa, looks to be in good condition.
Let's get this cleaned up. This journal is pretty special. The pages seem to be of fabric. Silver doesn't look great after being in the ocean. These banknotes are delicate, and we'll need a good rinsing in the desalination bath. Then we can treat them in the... This leather case is looking pretty sturdy, but it will need a good soaking in the desal tub to remove the salt. Then I can get a bone hair comb. I'll need to wash the salt out quickly before it crystallizes and the bone starts to crumble. It's ready for drying in the acetone bath. Now it's clean, it needs to be soaked in PEG and fungicide to soften the leather and stop it from cracking. Alright, it's ready for freeze drying.